It so you can either start out like that. You can start out with a drum beat if you want, like that, or you can start out with an introduction. C is empty. There's nothing there. So I decided to take the polka beat off of here, move it into 1C, so that whenever I press 1C, I will go... So, I decided to start out with an accordion. So by pressing this button, I put my jazz band in there. I can change the backgrounds as I'm playing. I can change the backgrounds as I'm doing a chorus. I can start with just a trombone. Let's see. album coming out of two different amps, stereo, or two different channels. Anywhere I want, I can direct it. Now, I wanted to leave out the everything except the accompaniment. In that sound is I mix the vibes in with the guitar. Like the musicians.
You gotta be shooting with that digital. Get the digital sound and better picture.
Go get your... I'm using that for photo book. That's all I use that for.
Still got your,
it won't hurt your photos.
Yeah, breaks up the
continuity. If I'm doing a cha-cha, I got all the Latin. I got about 32 different drum bits in here. Got a whole Latin section. And it's so good. I hear something going on here that I don't like, I can knock it all out while I'm playing. I can knock everything out, all the Latin sounds out, bring it back in again. Waltz, it says go to 9D. So I have it programmed, so when I go to 9D, I should have a... Let's see what we get. Now, if I don't like this, what I'm doing an Italian number, and I might start like without any background. Tremolo it just like... Italian folk comes on with an accordion. When I come to the chorus, I press this button. Mandolin comes on automatically.
You and Trudy could go on a cruise and they could just show you the Adrian. You guys could show the Adrian again.
Yeah.
You could do that real easy.
But if I decide, I'm just playing what I have programmed in here for this particular file. But if I decide I want to do a string section in here,
rad.
When I do marches, like when I march people to dinner, I have it all programmed, so I go to 15D. When I press 15D, band, it says Glockenspiel here, see? So I press that. Now, if you're going to do disco, just know that if I press 5D like that, yeah, that's what he likes. So I go to, it says Dixie CA2, and it says press 2E. So I go to registration, I press E, I press 2, and what comes on the screen? Dixieland. Let's see what we got. So I go to folk card, that's what the F stands for, and I press D16 because I've entered all that data into that one.
Oh,
something?
Yeah, I do. I'll tell you.
Gotta show Gene the bluegrass.
Rocky Top.
20 to ship it.
You'd have to pay me to take it. Red Bruns can fix stuff like that.
Thank you. I thought you might be interested in my latest toy. This is my electronic drum set that Carlene was kind enough to buy for me. She always noticed that when I was in the car, I'd be tapping on the steering wheel or something, so she wanted to get me some drums. I'm not a drummer. I've never had a lesson. I've never even sat behind a set of drums, but I enjoy it, and it's a lot of fun. And I'll stay here for hours by myself playing. But what I wanted to point out to you is the realistic sound that these electronic drums have. And there's so much involved, you can put so many sounds in and customize it to whatever you want. And I've set this thing up for the type of music that I like. But for an example, this would be your snare sound. This would be another snare, and this is a tom-tom, this is a lower tom-tom. In drums you go from high to low, I learned that, higher, lower. This would be like a Chinese gong at the end, and this is a ride, what they call a ride cymbal. This is another ride cymbal, and this, if you can get the cameras over here, I'll show you how this works. This is called a hi-hat. This is similar to on a drum set where you see the two cymbals coming together. And what happens here is, that's just a light cymbal, but when you hit this pad, it stops it like that. Gives that sound. On the rims, you can bring different sounds. You notice sometimes a drummer hits the rim of the drums. Well, we can't get that that way to work here, but I've set up the rims with their own sounds. For example, well, this is a Chinese gong. If I hit the rim, I got like a bell sound. Well, this is a tom-tom. This is the closest to what a drum would sound when he hits it on the rim. Another tom-tom. That's a cymbal. This is a block, like Chinese block. Snare. That's called a cowbell. Up here, it's a ride cymbal. This is kind of what they call a splash, which you hear in old-time music. A ride. And this would be a crash cymbal that we use like at the end of a song. This one stays the way it is. I'll put a little song on just to give you an idea. Work a minute. See if I can work in the Chinese clock. These drummers are worse. They're dead now. Best in the world. It's fun to try to emulate them. Here we go.
Citrus fruit.
What, the tangelo?
Yeah, because it's a rare fruit. They don't sell them up north very much because they don't hold up. And there's only about a 6-week window where you can pick them. So we can pull some down for you. And I got one other tree with tangerine.
Yeah, but he said, when you come back and buy
and they come here and they help themselves. All they do is take the low ones.
Oh, that's the way you do that, huh?
Isn't that neat?
Yeah, because these guys have picked all my easy-to-pick ones. So now I got to start.
Here we are down at Sid's. February the 14th, 1999. Picking grapefruit, oranges, and tangerines. Yeah, wait a minute. Turn around here. I want to see you. I got 10188 now. Here's the guy that lives.
You know that address by heart. You don't have to look on the wall for
that. Yeah, they said, wonder what the number is. What did I say, Gene? 10188. That was planted from, you planted a coconut.
Planted a coconut right here.
Planted it right there.
Yeah.
And it turned into a coconut tree.
Yeah.
That's a coconut tree.
It's a coconut palm. It's been a little tree up until recently. It suddenly started to grow. But you can see the coconuts up in there.
Yep. Yep, there are.
Oh, yeah. Now that palm in back of Bob is called an areca palm. The palms, there's hundreds of varieties of them. See that palm straight ahead?
Yeah.
It's one of the most beautiful palms. You have to keep it trimmed. It takes a lot of pruning. But that's called an areca palm tree. And these palm trees you're seeing right here in front of you are not coconut palms. These are called queen palms. And they're a real pain in the neck, and nobody likes them. They look nice, but you have to take care of them because they get a lot of junk on them that falls off.
What's that stuff lay up there? It looks like moss.
Yeah, that's seeding. It goes to seed. That's how it goes to seed. It looks like a horse mane.
Yeah?
Yeah. But you can see a difference when you look at the coconut.
These are bananas. 3 weeks old bananas right here in the backyard. The one, the only, Sid Kleiner, right here. Mr. Farmer.
Not really. These I planted from pits. We ate the mangoes from a musician friend of mine who has since passed away. And this summer it looks like we're going to have real
mangoes,
edible mangoes here. Yeah. Now mango is very sensitive to cold. So if you get 28 degrees for a few hours, this tree will die. It can't handle cold at all. It's a tropical tree. But I started with three pits here, really.
Put them in the ground, plant them, and they come up from there?
Yep.
How long ago was that?
That's about 8-9 years ago.
Very good.
And they were hurt by frost 2 or 3 times. They see over here on the second tree, both planted at the same time. This is also from 3 pits. Over here, you get an idea of how the mango blossoms. And that's why they don't grow well in the anywhere north of here, because the slightest frost is going to kill us.
Now what's there? Each one of them would make a mango?
Mangoes, here they are.
Baby mangoes.
Yep.
I'll be dang gone.
This is what they look like. You see, it starts with the blossom, just as you saw it on the other one there. And then it grows from the blossom to this. And then only a handful of each one on each branch will survive the winter. And you start harvesting these around July. That's why you can't grow these up in Ohio, because they need all this year, right up until July, to mature.
So got a long mango, growing season.
That's why you don't grow oranges up there, same reason.
Long, long growing season.
See? And that's why, I say, if you have 28 degrees for 6 hours, that's it.
That's it, huh?
That's the end of the whole tree. Yeah. These, uh-oh.
What?
There's a pineapple.
Uh-oh, first.
Yeah, I got to tell Judy about that. We're going to have a baby. Here's a pineapple growing. There it is.
Yes, it is.
It's a pineapple.
There's a pineapple right there.
Yep.
We was here when you found the first pineapple.
Yeah. So what you do is you can take any pineapple top that you buy in the supermarket, and they're now $4 or $5 for a decent pineapple, and you just plant the top, the part you don't eat, you just plant it. And then this is what happens when you plant a pineapple top.
Yeah, but they wouldn't grow up north.
Oh, no. No way. You could grow them in a house. And I let it stay And then I realized what we're growing here is a papaya.
Papaya.
This is a papaya. Now the thing about papayas is that they're like human beings. You have to have a male and a female, and this appears to be a male, so it's never going to have any fruit on it unless I move, and I've got some papayas growing back in there. I've got to move a couple of papaya plants here so that they can mate. This will never produce any fruit.
How can you tell a male?
Hey, Bob, come here.
How can you tell a male and a female?
You want to see camouflage? There's a little lizard, and he changes color.
Oh, yeah.
You see him?
Chameleon?
Yeah. He changes color with anything he's on.
Yeah, he keeps going.
Yeah, he's over here now. He's over here.
Yeah, I see him. Just keep your finger. I'm gonna.
Here he is.
I'm gonna zoom in close. If I can get him in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if you're not observant, this guy will be right in front of your eyes,
and
you'll
never see him.
You'll never see him.
Yeah, he changes colors and what he's on.
He changes color. If he gets on a leaf here, he'll be a bright.
She loved that stuff. Oh. What's the other? There's another fruit.
Guava. Guava is the big one there. Breadfruit.
Where
are they visiting?
And this is fire ants in Naples, Florida.
They're taking over the country, those fire ants. And there's no way to get rid of them except what we're doing. That's about it. You can buy this Ampro.
That's as big as
Over their heads.
That's as big as a grapefruit up where we're at. They're orange. That's as big as an orange.
I'm going to get another nice lemon here.
Watch out for them fire ants. Over their heads. You got to get him by box. He tried to take a picture and catch anything.
One more, Jim.
Here, I'll catch it. I'll catch it.
I got one hand.
Okay.
I got to hand you video.
Okay.
Those are lemons.
Lemons? They have the biggest oranges up our place.
These lemons here, squeeze this lemon, and you'll get quarter of a cup of the juice out of one of those
Wait,
lemons.
Up at Joyce's on Sanibel, she's got lemons as big as your grapefruit.
Here. You want to see him? Come here.
Ponderosa lemon. How big is a grapefruit?
Not to be confused with a steakhouse.
Yeah, now, not the Ponderosa steakhouse. This is a Ponderosa lemon. Hell, that's big as your hand. Big as a grapefruit.
This reminds me of Dolly Parton here.
Yeah.
Looks like bull's balls to me.
This is like going to Dollywood here.
Yeah.
Sid's holding a bull's bag over there.
Since it's still a little.
They make perfume from these, you know. They pick these and they squeeze the oil out of them, and that's how they make perfume.
Yeah, that's interesting.
You can get a good close-up on him.
Yeah, because this has got that 22-to-1 zoom.
I never took his picture. He's been here for months.
Well, I got it. I got him now, sitting here under the orange tree. Here is a coffee maker, right here.
I don't know, I never made it.
You never made it?
I was making it for the two of us,
Make it for two, and then we're drinking, and make it for two more.
Yeah. Let's see, I usually put in here six for two, so it would be for one more, it would be another half of six.
Well, just make that, and then if we run, because it won't take that. That's just do it like you normally do.
Eight.
And then you do it again.
But you know, the more you make, I don't know if you need less coffee. You know, it doesn't work that way.
Well, the more.
Mr. Ballone is country club here, and play tennis, and it's a golf club. And we own what do you call it when you own part of it? Bonds. And I sold them. One of the things
Look, they're playing ball. It rained all night, and they're playing ball.
Oh, yeah.
And all year
long.
Fast.
All year long. And one thing that intrigued me when I first moved here, I said, look at them playgrounds. It's 10 o'clock at night. All the lights are on. They keep them damn lights on all night, encouraging the kids to get out there and get away from watching the TV and Dick Clark and rock and roll and all that. Get out there and play baseball and basketball and all that stuff.
It's amazing how few bugs you do have down here. Most
get them involved in something.
And these damn fields, they're like polished.
Hey,
man,
this is real baseball. Let's watch him pitch a couple times.
Yeah, look at the fields. Look, it's like a professional.
It rained right away, didn't it?
Look, umpires.
It's a real game here.
Yeah, these look like
that guy's a real umpire, too.
The kids are a little older.
Hey, there's a man on third. Let me get out.
You want me to park?
I just want to see. This is neat. This is a real baseball game.
Alrighty. Thank you, sir. Number 7, right?
No, I have to go. I have no idea. We tease him and then we say, Simon.
Hello, Steve. Can you think you can do that?
Drink water?
No. Oh. Play hockey.
It shoots way up. That's what it is. I knew it was. Okay.
It's a swimming pool with a quart bottle.
And you can go up in there and look out the eyes and all that stuff. And you can go up in there. It's great for kids.
Play it forward, and wherever I stop it, we're always in. My picture didn't come out of that reel. It was all the way. I'm going to keep it a little bit until it starts. Mistake that NBC made a few weeks ago announcing his death.
Yeah. Highly exaggerated, like Mark Twain said.
Yeah.
This is nice on a Sunday. You get a parking space in the parking lot. You come here, have a couple brews if you want. The beach. They put the palm trees on the beach. And it's really nice.
I video you videoing me, Steve.
We did that stick.
Huh?
We did that stick.
Well, is that the two-step or the four-step?
That's the old shag.
Every where we go, there's video. Yes. Well, you're on three video cameras at one time. Why they crew? All right, here, skip to my loop. Get this 6602 thing.
Hey. Come on,
man.
Hold the door.
Oh, I want to get him as we. Hey, yes. The bridge inspector, right?
He was watching with the bridge man.
The bridge man, how you doing, Bill? Yeah. We apologize for dropping in on you, but yeah, a couple years older.
This is what you do on Sunday.
Billy Berryman. Billy Berryman. We got a weak ward. I still think he's having a bad dream.
Yeah, could be at this point in the day.
He worked all night.
He works those crazy.
There's that table we sat at and used to argue when we come down to see John.
Oh, yeah, you go around cook steaks and around on the table.
We ate steaks right there at that table. Bullshit repellent.
He sprayed me all over.
Videotape it all. You didn't find any of that stuff in there? Did you ever look at any of his tapes or anything?
Oh, yeah, you know, from time to time.
He was one of a kind, that guy. You got a lot of remembrances right here, I see.
Oh, yeah, all the paintings.
Great.
He was a hell of an artist, you know it?
Yeah, we should have come down here. We didn't know when Ward called us that he really was wanting to get rid of us.
I know who was here. Lemo 1 a.m.
Oh, okay.
Here we are at John's, 6602.
Hey, that's your dad's car. That was here.
That's the car he let you use to go over and see that postmaster.
Yeah.
Who's driving that
one? My brother.
The Knuckle's out there?
Yeah, just bought that a year ago.
That's a Saturn.
Yes, sir.
Gorgeous car.
Well, Sid, and Trudy, and all the Kleiner clan, hope you enjoyed this little raw video of our trip to Florida. And Sid, that right at the end there, that was Billy Bearman. We stopped by John's house, didn't get to see Ward, he was sleeping because he'd worked all night, but that was Billy Bearman. We only stayed there maybe 10 minutes, just stopped and chatted with him. But we had a great trip in Florida. Hope you enjoyed some of this raw video. You'll be seeing more of it on the Round Robins and different things. We had a great, great, great trip. 8 hectic days. And man, we crowded a lot into those 8 days. So hope you're feeling okay, Sid, and hope Trudy is doing okay. We're hanging in here in Cincinnati, Ohio. Today is March the 19th. I've got to go pick Belinda up from the pain clinic at about 1:30. She's going to call me, let me know what time she's going to get out. So, it don't look too good. Don't look too good. This breaks my heart, Sid. Breaks my heart. Take care. See you. We'll be talkie-yacking, I guess, on audio tapes or videotapes or something. But take care. Bye-bye from old Bob in Cincinnati, Ohio. It's